امبارح حكينا على الشاكرونز وحكينا انه هذول الشاكرونز هم they are large, it's a large complex of proteins. هذول بيساعدوا other proteins to be folded and some proteins cannot fold to their proper final structure by themselves. They need help. These proteins, what happens, you know, if they don't get help, once they are synthesized, the different hydrophobic regions immediately tend to cluster. Hydrophobic interaction. ممكن improper, the wrong, the inaccurate hydrophobic interaction ممكن يصير between different regions of the same peptide. أو ممكن تكون عندنا different peptide regions of different polypeptides. Hydrophobic region of one peptide, hydrophobic region of another peptide, they tend to cluster. And this is a problem with protein folding and resulting in what we call an aggregation, an aggregate, a protein aggregate, in a cluster of proteins. These proteins, by cluster of proteins, precipitate, metastasize in tissues, and they can be toxic. They use ATP, they take the polypeptide, عاملين زي البرميل, بدخل البوليبيبتايد and they help the protein in folding properly. فبيجي بحط الهيدروفوبيك ريجن هذا مع الهيدروفوبيك ريجن الصح اللي بياخذ الريجن هذا بحطه على الريجن الثاني and so on. So slowly وبعدين it releases it. Okay. فهذول الشابرونز that's how they function. So they prevent the formation of protein aggregates. هلا what happens when proteins aggregate الهيدروفوبيك ريجنز of proteins when they aggregate, they will form what we call a plaque. Plaque is a dark spot in tissues. هذول في البرين structures بنعملوا fibers, fibrillar structures لأنهم كثير ما يتراكموا على بعض بنسميهم amyloid in brain tissues. And they can be insoluble, causing cell death. I'll give you two examples of problems associated with protein aggregation as well as protein misfolding. Leprion disease. Leprion disease, when they discovered it decades ago, they were looking for bacteria, viruses. They couldn't find a cause in Leprion disease. What is Leprion disease? Now what happens in the field, we have a protein known as a prion. It has its own function, a prion protein. Normally, this protein is mainly made of alpha helices. Now, something happens, resulting in a change in protein conformation, whereby the alpha helices become beta strands. So the protein becomes full of beta sheets, rather than being a helical protein over. With a lot of helices. That results in something else. In a higher level protein that is misfolded tends to interact with other proteins of the same type, other prion proteins, changing their conformation from being full of alpha helices to beta strands. And the two proteins cluster while interact with each other. These two proteins then can interact with additional prion proteins, forming an aggregate, large cluster of prion proteins. And all, they tend to precipitate in the brain, central nervous system, resulting in cell damage. This disease is infectious. And it can happen spontaneously, and it becomes bad luck. Or it can be inherited. And it's a subtle mutation in the prion gene itself, causing causing misfolding of the protein, resulting in the formation of misfolded protein with aggregates and so on. And infectious, if it becomes infectious, not as a result of bacteria or viruses, no, it's by eating something that has prion or misfolded prion. But the prion disease, you are in the asthma. هو الماد كاو ديزيز مرض جنون البقر it's a prion disease okay the cows do have misfolded prions فإذا واحد أكل لحم مش مطبوخة من can be, the person can develop trigon disease. The cow mad cow disease, the sheep is most scrapies. The humans is more Jacob Creutzfeldt disease. Same thing, who are talking prion diseases and result, they result from eating something that has a misfolded prion. What about the mechanism? That's the prion, the misfolded prion goes into the central nervous system or it forms aggregate, protein aggregates for the central nervous system, resulting in whatever condition you can see. This is a properly folded prion protein. What happens when something happens in the conformation, the structure of the protein changes, whereby the alpha helices become beta strands. Okay? And something happens to this protein in the hydrophobic regions are exposed somehow. But this protein, the misfolded protein, would bind to a normal protein, changing its structure, the normal protein, changing its structure from alpha helices to beta strands. Okay? And these two, when they interact with each other, they will interact with other proteins, prion proteins, forming a protein aggregate. High protein aggregates are toxic, the tissues or the cells. So the tissues will tend to, or cells will tend to die as a result of that. And the harika, prion disease here, they eat monkey brains uncooked. It's disgusting, but it happens. اليوتيوب وسمعات وبسمع يعني اشياء مفيده sometimes. فامبارح مره بسمع ليكشر لانسان عظيم دراي اسمه وضاح خلفه كان مدير الجزيره سنوات 2006 ل 7 سنوات مهم العلم درس هم الاردنيه مش عارف ف بغض النظر هذا عاد يحكي انه لما يروح هو يسافر على اي بلد he makes sure that he has a meeting with a scientist, a prominent scientist in this country. He went to Australia. He made a meeting with a scientist. What is he doing? He said that after 15 years, he won't have laptops, he won't have mobile apps, he won't have TV, because everything will be inside the human body. All the sensors. الالكترونيك شيبس ومش عارف ايش جوا الجسم. فهذا الزلمه بيشتغل على السنسرز انه اذا انحطت بالجسم تعطي سيجنالز وتعطي انديكيشنز كيف حاله الشخص هذا. الشخص مثلا جوعان في تعبان ناقص سكر في شيء ابنورمال الليفر انزيمز طلعوا الليفر انزيمز نزلوا ايش الكونديشن تبعته. It's amazing. فبده يعمل ريسيرش، طبعا صعب انه يعمل ريسيرش على مين؟ على الانسان. فحط السنسرز هذه بالبقرة. It's amazing. وقعد يشوف السيجنالز ويحلل السيجنالز فشاف عرف امتى البقرة بتكون مرتاحة، امتى بتكون جوعانة، امتى بتكون في قمة نشاطها. اوكي؟ امتى بتنتج حليب؟ وايش هي الفاكتورز اللي بتاثر على انتاج الحليب؟ لما هو فهم هذه الاشارات تحكي انه انتاج الحليب بالمزرعه صار اضعف لانه عند البقره ايش بده؟ مشاعرها والكونديشنز تبعها. It's amazing الساينس اللي عماله بيصير. So نرجع على البايكوز. فهذا البرايم ديزيز. It's infectious, it can happen, it's hereditary, and it can happen spontaneous as well. And a common disease that can result from the formation of protein aggregates, is what Alzheimer's, I'll finish with Alzheimer's. Huh? What happens is, if I have tissue sections of the brain, the patients of Alzheimer's, right, show a few plaques, dark spots, and only aggregates of proteins, of one or two proteins. اللي هو الاميلويد بيبتايد او a tau, a protein known as tau. These two proteins can aggregate. When they studied Alzheimer's disease, they found, in terms of the amyloid, they knew the mechanism, the amyloid protein is an integral membrane protein. Any protein موجود على cell surface is cell بتعمل كل فترة والتانية renewal. بتشيل the proteins على cell surface وبتحط بدلهم proteins ثانية. بتقول بتجدد شكلها بتجددهم. So it's a normal process انه هذا ال amyloid protein is cleaved, it's cut at a certain point, releasing it. That's the normal process. What happens in patients with Alzheimer's disease when the cleavage point takes place at a different place, resulting in the formation of a peptide that is anaerobic. And this peptide tends to aggregate with similar peptides, resulting in the formation of a protein aggregate. This protein aggregate, again, is toxic to cells. فعشان هيك الشخص بده يخسر the brain cells, بده يخسر the memory control, the ability to eat, the ability to move, and so on. هذا عند patients with Alzheimer's disease. واضح؟ اوكي. نيجي على quaternary structure. اللي هو basically, it's not all proteins have quaternary structure. There are some proteins that do have it. منهم the proteins that are composed of multiple polypeptide chains. هذول proteins بنسميهم polymers. فلو عندي protein that is composed of one polypeptide chain, بنحكي it is a monomer. لو if it is made of two polypeptide chains, بنحكي انه it is a dimer. ثلاثة trimer, and so on. لو كانوا two chains the same, بنحكي انه it is a homodimer. If the two chains are different, بنحكي انه it is a heterodimer. واضح؟ نفس الشيء هومو تترمر وهترو تترمر and so on. فهذه so far the question is how are these different polypeptides connected to each other? Well, it depends on the protein. Immunoglobulins are tetramers, hetero tetramers. These two large chains are the same, and these two smaller chains are the same. That's a tetramer, it's a hetero tetramer. These chains are connected to each other covalently by disulfide linkages. Disulfide bonds between cysteines. Yeah. We have another example of a protein that is a tetramer, and it is a heterotetramer, who is hemoglobin. It's composed of four polypeptides, two alphas, two alpha chains, and two beta chains. And these four chains are connected to each other via electrostatic interactions as well as hydrophobic interactions. فممكن يكون عندي أنا formation of quaternary structures إما covalently أو non-covalently. So it depends on the protein. It's not restricted to a certain type or pattern. They have complex protein structures. إيش هم complex protein structures of complex proteins. These are the proteins that are composed of a protein, a polypeptide, plus a non-protein part. Okay? سواء كان metal أو حكينا على heme زي الهيموجلوبين أو كان sugar. These are all, أو كان lipids. These are all complex proteins. هلا البروتين اللي بيكون معاه non-protein part أو component أو group بنحكي إنه it is a monoprotein. البروتين اللي بدون a non-protein part, نحكي إنه it is an apoprotein. فأبو معناته إنه منزوع الجروب اللي هي non-protein, والهولو معناته إنه it is a protein with a non-protein part. Simple. فلما أجي أحكي apolipoprotein أو أحكي lipoprotein. Lipoprotein is a holoprotein. That it is made of lipids plus protein. كويس؟ بس إذا جيت حكيت apolipoprotein. protein. I'm talking about a protein that is normally linked or associated with lipids. But if I say apolipoproteins, the lipid parts are not there. I'm talking about the protein part only. Why? If I say apolipoprotein, I'm not talking about the whole complex. The protein, the polypeptide, the lipids. I'm only talking about the protein part of the complex. That's all. But I'm talking about the protein without the lipid part. حكينا عن الجلايكوبروتينز هذا هيك بالمحاضرة الكربوهيدرات وحكيت لكم على أهمية الشجر مولكيولز إنه إيش بتعمل الشجر مولكيولز cell cell recognition prolonging the half life of the protein the function of the protein the protein folding أشياء اللي حكيت لكم عنها. So glycoproteins are proteins that have some sugar groups associated with it or moieties. هلا and they are associated covalently with proteins. An example is immunoglobulins. لحكينا عنهم قبل هيك اللي هم في disulfide linkages connecting the four polypeptides to each other. زائد ممكن يكون عليهم sugar molecules as well. So these are immunoglobulins or glycoproteins. I tend to ask questions where I gather information from different lectures. فأنا حكيت عن immunoglobulins before. In a separate lecture. Here, I'm talking about immunoglobulins right now. A few slides back, I talked about immunoglobulins as well. But ممكن إنه وراح نحكي عن immunoglobulins later on. So I can, in the final example, I can ask questions where I gather different information from different lectures. But جمع هاي المعلومات عن بعض as you study. Immunoglobulins, حكى عن immunoglobulins in the doctor. Oh, excellent. طب إيش حكى عنهم؟ حكى عنهم إنه هيك. حكى عنهم إنه هيك. And so on. طب ايش هم الجلايكوبروتينز؟ How are sugars associated مع البروتينز؟ By connecting to certain amino acids. And عندي and we have two types of linkages. We have what we call an N-linked. We have N-linked proteins or sugars. N-linked sugars and we have O-linked sugars. واضحة ايش هي الN؟ N يعني نيتروجين والO يعني أكسجين. N-linked sugars are sugars that are connected covalently to asparagine, which is a polar amino acid that has an amino group, right? It's not linked to the glutamine. I know it can be a similar structure, but it's not asparagine only. With all linked sugars, these are sugars that are associated with amino acids that have hydroxyl groups, specifically serine and threonine. Okay? Then tyrosine, but tyrosine is not glycosidic. In some cases, serine, threonine, asparagine. In some cases, or in case of collagen, collagen can be glycosidic. بس مش على السيرين ولا الترينين ولا الاسبارجين على مين؟ على الهيدروكسيلايزين فلما يصير في عندنا سينثيسيس للكولاجين some of the lysine residues are hydroxylated فبتصير اسمه هيدروكسيلايزين and these hydroxylysine residues can be glycosylated we can attach sugars to them فالكولاجين is a glycoprotein and that's how it gets glycosylated. Finally, other types of proteins and other lipoproteins, نحكينا عنهم قبل HDL, VLDL, and so on, IDL and LDL. وحكينا كمان انه and some other proteins can be phosphorylated. So these are phosphoproteins. راح نحكي عن phosphorylation as a mechanism of regulating protein function. It's very important in regulating protein function. So these are known as phosphoproteins. And I'm done with this lecture.